إن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. فإن شاء الله we are starting a small booklet, not much, few pages, about when you are sick, how you are able to perform your wudu or your tayammum, and when you are sick, how you should pray. That shows the importance of the salah. The salah is required from you. If you are mentally fit, salah is required from you, regardless of your physical disability. It will never be waved away from you. So in that case, you have to learn to pray the salah, the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And from that point, you have to learn when you have difficulties, how you should pray. We see a lot of the times the people, they ignore their salah because they are busy, they are working, they are on the bus, they are on the this, that's not acceptable. Allah created you to perform the salah, put on one side. Allah created you to worship. And the first of the worship, of the amal, is a salah. So salah required from you by any condition. It will never waive it from you. You can get excuse for the fasting, you can get excuse for the hajj, you can get excuse for zakah, but when it came the point of the salah, it required from you. Regardless of your sickness, regardless of your disability, regardless of your busy, it required from you. So that's how it shows the importance of the salah. So inshallah, tonight we start the booklet of Sheikh Uthaymeen. كيف يتطهر المريض ويصلي. The sick person, how they purify, either wudu or tayammum or ghusl, and how they should pray. And how they should pray. Lesson number one. So how the sick person purifies and prays. Before we start the booklet, we have to give some introduction for the importance of the salah. How the salah is important. أهمية الصلاة. The importance of the salah. من فضائل الصلاة, the virtue of the salah. Salah have some virtue which are different than rest of the ibadah. So what is it? Number one, فرضها الله على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Allah obligated it on the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. بدون واسطة, without any intermission, without anyone to be in between Allah and the Prophet. All ibadat, all sharia, all the religion has been sent by, through Jibreel. Jibreel used to bring to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When it comes to the salah, Jibreel was not in there. Prophet Allah came to the Prophet directly. That shows the importance of the salah. Yeah. No intermediator. That's number one. ولا نعلم شيئا فرض. And we don't know any ibadah which has been obligated upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam without intermediation, except the salat al-khams, the fard salah.